Hello students, I'm Anita Jomi Thomas, assistant professor from Department of Management, and today I'm going to present a small video session on negotiation. So what is basically negotiation? You might have heard about it. We generally coincide or we try to explain this term with another term called as bargaining. But negotiation, if I say, while conducting business or working in an organization, conflicts are bound to happen. Hence, negotiation is often required to develop a harmonious relation or a solution for all the parties involved in conflict. So, what is negotiation? Negotiation is a method by which people settle disagreements or differences. It is a process by which parties to negotiation compromise or reach an argument or agreement while avoiding unnecessary arguments and dispute. Throughout the negotiation process, considerable skill in communication, decision making, and use of power and politics is required in order to succeed. So, it's very crucial. What I'm trying to say here is that it's very crucial for people involving in negotiation to be a good communicator, should have a good decision making ability, also should have certain amount of power, and sometimes may need to play politics. Now, your negotiation basically is of two types, distributive bargaining and integrative bargaining. Now, what is this distributive bargaining? Here, the amount of resources available to be divided will be fixed. Whereas under integrative bargaining, the amount of resources is going to be variable. Now, under distributive bargaining, win-lose situation is always cropping up. Because here what happens is that the negotiator tries to win the negotiation and makes the opponent lose. Whereas in case of integrative bargaining, there is going to be a mutual benefit. That is, win-win situation tends to arise. Now remember, under distributive bargaining, the views or you can say the conflicts or even the opinions are going to be completely opposing to each other. Whereas in case of integrative bargaining, it is going to be convergent with each other. Here, under distributive bargaining, short-term relations are focused on. Whereas in integrative bargaining, a long-term relationship is focused upon. The other one is that under distributive negotiation, the negotiation becomes very competitive. And so other party is viewed as a competitor. Whereas under integrative bargaining, it is more of a collaborative in nature and people tend to negotiate on friendly terms. While if you say about distributive bargaining, the negotiator only focuses on his personal interest. That is, he is going to focus on meeting his own interest regardless of the losses which the other party is going to make. Whereas in case of integrative bargaining, the negotiator always focuses that there is a win-win situation or both the party comes up in such a manner that both the parties fulfill their interest. So it is more of constructive in nature. Now, let's move on to another important step. We call it as the steps to negotiation or process of negotiation. The first and foremost step is preparation and planning. The negotiator here has to identify the need and cause of negotiation, the goals of the organization and the other parties, etc. He must also plan the best alternative to negotiated agreement. We call it as BATNA, which reveals the minimum achievement level. On the basis of BATNA, the strategy is decided accordingly. The second step under negotiation process is defining the ground rules. Once planning and strategy is done, the negotiating parties have to decide the ground rules for negotiation. That is, when, where, at what time, also the initial demands of the negotiation will be expressed here. The third stage is clarification and justification. At this stage, the parties will clarify and justify their demands, the problems associated with it, and other solutions will be suggested or explained. The fourth process or the fourth step is bargaining and problem solving. The actual process of bargaining or negotiation happens at this stage, wherein the parties do step back on their demands to a certain extent, made and also agree upon problem solving so that good agreements can be made. Or you can say the outcome needs to be good, where both the parties benefit in a mutual way. The fifth and the last stage is closure and implementation. The process of negotiation comes to an end at this stage and agreed solutions are implemented. Now, for arriving at negotiation, if I say, there are few approaches which is adopted by the negotiators. The first approach is called as win-win approach. When I talk about win-win, as the name suggests, both the parties will be coming up with those suggestions where the outcomes are going to be positive for both. So that's called as win-win approach. Then second one is win-lose approach. Now, when I talk about win-lose approach, here one party, say it would be me, the party wins and the opponent loses. The third approach is lose-win situation, where maybe me or I would be losing as compared to my opponent. That is, my opponent would be gaining, or I could be saying that the individual is going to have an upper hand in terms of his or her interest. Whereas the last approach is lose-lose approach, where both the parties do not come to a proper agreement and here the outcomes are going to be negative. Usually, win-win approach is what every negotiator has to concentrate on. Now, let's come to the last point or the last topic for today, that is issues in negotiation. Now, what are the general problems that you view or see while negotiating? Number one, it is personality trait of individual. The traits of individuals can be definitely a problematic issue. Some people can be very judgmental, some can be way too overconfident, some are going to be very aggressive, etc. So what happens in these situations? It is going to affect or it will give a negative impact on the outcomes. The second issue is general, or you can say general gender differences. When I'm talking about these gender differences, though even researchers don't prove it to a greater extent, but somewhere or the other, while negotiation or while people negotiate, outcomes basically tend to favor males as compared to females. So you can say many a times females do exhibit lesser confidence in anticipation to the negotiation being done, or are very less satisfied with the results which they get out of negotiation, whereas males tends to get an upper hand. This is not a conclusive one, but still gender differences are small issues. The third one is cultural difference. This is a great influencer, as negotiation styles differs across countries and culture and can have a positive or negative impact on negotiation outcomes. Like for example, some people or some country people can be very submissive, some can be orthodox, so conservative, all such kind of things are possible. The next one is tendency to rely on available information. This is a crucial thing. Let me tell you, all people have this ability, or we basically rely upon what information we get, but we do not know what is the source of information. Is the information correct? We may not be so sure, but whatever we hear, we tend to rely upon those informations. The last one is self-centered goals. Most of the negotiators here aim at attaining only their goals, ignore the opponent's goals. This is also an issue in negotiation. Thank you for watching. And this was all the thing from my side. Thank you once again. Stay tuned in for more videos.